Hello and welcome to this tutorial on creating and manipulating assemblies in SpaceClaim. So here we're moving on past sort of the basic tools. You know, we looked at pull, move, fill, combine, and the blend, of course. But now, you know, we want to move a little bit beyond just sort of the basics. So one thing we can do that's quite powerful in SpaceClaim is we can create assemblies. Basically what that means is, you know, we have, you know, for example, workshop 2, base screw, bracket. These are all names for components, and those components, you know, contain the various sort of solids. So if I hover over bracket, you'll see, you know, it highlights that component with this sort of orange box. And then if I hover over, you know, the solid, it shows, you know, the so you can have multiple, you know, surfaces, solids, etc., within a single component, and sort of treat that component as, you know, a single unit. And the nice thing about components is you'll notice, you know, with solids, you know, sometimes if you're doing operations with solids, and you know, you say for example, I drag this solid, I move this solid up here, and you know, into just so sort of intersecting. It's hard to you know, hard to see from this angle, but try to get that sort of intersect that. Now if I, you know, if I for some reason I decided, you know, I want to make a change, if I start, you know, pulling on this and let go, you know, now all of a sudden we've got these two solids and they've combined into a single solid. That's not quite what we want. We want it to sort of maintain these as two separate units, but for whatever reason they touched and we made some change and now they're, you know, combined into one solid. Not quite what we wanted. So I'm just going to go back, Control Z, before we moved that piece. And now what I can do is I can say, okay, well, I want this, you know, I want to treat this as a separate entity. I don't want it to, you know, accidentally merge with anything else. So I'm going to right-click on that solid in the structure tree, and I'm going to click on Move to New Component. And that's going to move it to a new component. I can give it a name here, you know, sleeve or whatever. Not sure what it's supposed to be, but I'm just taking a wild guess there. And if I want to, you know, I can take this object here. I can make it, you know, an assembly using move to a new component. Now, let me show you, though, a quicker way. If you have, like, a whole bunch of solids and you want to put them each in their own new component, there's a simpler way. I'm just going to back up here until we have go back to our two solids there. And this time I'm going to select both solids, so Control-click the two solids in the structure tree. And now when I right-click, you'll notice now I have this option, move each to new component. I do that, and then I get these two. It's just going to give them default names, and I can always go, you know, if I click and then click again on that name, I can start typing in a new name. So I think I called that sleeve last time. Once again, I'm going to click. No, I'm not double clicking, but I click once, and then I click again, and then I can type in the name. So I'm going to call this nut. So now that we have, you know, our assembly, we have everything sort of tucked away in its nice component. We can sort of clean it up a bit there, hide all those ugly solid, unnamed solids. Now I just have like these bits here, and you know, I know I want to sort of assemble these in a particular way. Right now they're kind of all, you know, in different orientations and whatnot. But one thing that I can do that's rather neat is when I have the once I have these components, I can then assemble them using these handy tools here: align, tangent, orient. So I'm going to show you. Just the align tool. You can play around with these other tools if you want. They all sort of work. You can look into how they work. I'm going to show you the align tool because it's quite useful in this instance. So I'm going to click on align. It says pick geometry to align to the picked reference. So I'm going to, you know, I want maybe this cylinder to align with, you know, these cylinders here. So I'm going to click on, you know, this. The reference I want to align it to is this. And notice now, you know, it puts it in line with that cylinder. Now I don't want it sort of sticking through. I want this sort of this end here to be sticking past here. What I can do now is I can click on, again, the thing I want to align, and then what I want to align it to, this face here. And notice now it's going to move that component, and that face is going to be flush with this other face, and we have this nice assembly. Now maybe I realize this thing is sort of it's like an arm or something. It's going to pivot off this column here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this geometry here. Say I want to align that with this. Again, it's not quite what I expected, but I'm going to click on this face. I want to align it with this face. I'm just going to move it, and there. In this way, you can kind of move all the pieces around. Maybe I want to, align this with this collar here, then move it down to here. And with just a few clicks, you can see, I can get this lined up and all the parts lined up nicely. And that's basically it for alignment and working with assemblies. So feel free to play around with that. You can download this file and play around with it yourself. Try to see if you can get it, back to this state. So thank you very much for watching. I hope that was helpful.